Need to share a video with audio during a Microsoft Teams meeting? Well, what used to only be possible in Windows is now also possible in macOS. What I'll show you today is currently in public preview, but depending on when you're watching this, there's a pretty good chance that you'll see the controls I'll demonstrate today in your Teams experience. And if not, keep watching. I will show you how to enable public preview. And if you don't even see that, I'll show you what your Teams admin needs to do to configure it to make public preview available to you today. So with that, let's get started. So I'm on a MacBook in a Teams meeting, and I want to share a video that's running in YouTube, but this could be anything or any app. With sound running in a Mac or a PC, it's the same process. So when I hit the share tray, you'll see I have a new option to include computer sound, and that I can toggle on before I share my desktop. So I'll go ahead and enable that. I'll select the desktop in this case, and I'll also hit play on my previous video that's explaining this process using Windows, which by the way is more or less still the same. Now let me switch over to Adele's view, and you can hear that she's getting the incoming audio, and you hear the sound coming through. But one note about my previous video, I said that macOS will share audio without using this capability I'm showing today. You know, that was true if audio was coming out of your Mac speakers. macOS in this case is different from Windows, where Windows will usually succeed in terms of noise canceling speaker sound and getting that completely to go away. But this approach of sharing speaker audio doesn't always work if you're wearing headphones or just want the sound to be better than what you can achieve maybe using the speakers and the microphone pickup. So let's switch back over to the Mac, and I'll show you the second option to share or unshare computer sound during the meeting. Now, if I move my cursor to the top of the screen, you'll see another couple of screen sharing controls. I'm going to pin this for now. And here you can use this button between Give Control and Stop Presenting to turn off or turn on sharing computer sound. Now, the diagonal slash means that it's off, and no slash means it's on. And using that control means you don't need to stop sharing, then enable computer sound, then reshare your screen. Both of these control types are available, by the way, in both Windows and macOS. So the same steps I just demonstrated apply to Windows as well. So now I'll leave the meeting. Okay, so if you've made it this far and have realized this option isn't available in your Teams app on macOS, let me show you how you'd enable it. So in Teams, click on your image in the upper right-hand corner, go to About, and if you don't have this check mark next to Public Preview, click on it, and Teams will ask you to restart the Teams app. And once you log back in, you'll be in the public preview, and you should see the option then to include computer sound once you start sharing content. Now, the very first time that you try out that option on your Mac, it's going to ask you to install a driver, and after that it'll work like I demonstrated earlier. Finally, if you don't see the public preview option from before, that's because your Teams admin doesn't have this enabled in the Teams admin center. And if you're the Teams admin, you'll find it under Teams, Update Policies, and Show Preview Features. Just go ahead and turn that on, and you can also scope it to only the users who actually need it, maybe your group of macOS users, and they'll see the options for enabling public preview appear soon. So that was another quick working from home tip, and if you want to see more like this, check out aka.ms/wfhmechanics for more. Be sure to subscribe to our channel, and as always, thanks for watching.